Sandy Phillips of San Antonio, Texas, was 10 years old when she received her first gun as a present from her parents, who were avid hunters.
So I have a lot of respect for weapons. I also have a lot of respect for life. And sometimes those two do not go well together.
July 20th of last year, her 24-year-old daughter, Jessica Gowie, died, shot twice in an Aurora, Colorado movie theater.
I got a phone call from the young man that was with her, Brent, telling me that there had been a random shooting. And I asked him if he was okay, and he said, "I think I've been shot twice." And I said, "Where's Jesse?" And he said, "I'm sorry." And at that point, I guess I was screaming from what my husband has told me. And I was screaming, "Please tell me she's not dead." And then my daughter was also taken out of the theater by two policemen that came across her body, and she was still breathing. She was dying, but she was still breathing. And they picked her up and put her in the back of a cruiser with an officer blue who held her as she was dying.
The shooting happened on a Friday. Phillips was scheduled to visit her daughter the following Tuesday. Jessica had just moved to Aurora. Right before the movie started, Jessica sent her mom these text messages that she shares with us.
"Last thing she said to me was, 'I need my mama.'" She texted that at the theater. She said, "I can't wait for you to get here. I need my mama." And I wrote back that, "I need my baby girl." And that was the last thing we said to one another.
Now Sandy Phillips, who is still a gun owner and has been a member of the NRA, has become a strong voice for gun control.
James Holmes allegedly bought, I think, 4 guns and thousands of...
6,000 rounds of ammunition on the internet. And yet you and I have to go through a screening every time we get on a plane. Does that make sense?
Phillips wants to see anyone buying a gun undergo a background check. And she wants assault weapons to be banned.
There were people who will say, "We have a Second Amendment. This is in the Constitution, in the United States Constitution, and that right is protected in the U.S. Constitution."
The Second Amendment says that we are entitled to bear arms. It doesn't say what kind of arms, number one. Number two, it was written a long time ago when the only weapon that we had was a musket.
Sandy Phillips and Jessica were very close. It was hard for Phillips to let her daughter leave the nest, but she cheered on Jessica in her pursuit as an aspiring sports journalist. It's the little things now that Phillips misses the most.
Text messages that came throughout the day. The tweets that she was famous for. Little sass, crass, and class, as she put it. She was that feisty, lively, outgoing, loving, funny girl. And I miss everything about her. Everything.
And Sandy Phillips has been working with the Brady campaign to prevent gun violence and supports President Obama's gun control proposals. The NRA, in a statement on the Obama administration's proposal, said, quote, "Throughout its history, the National Rifle Association has led efforts to promote safety and responsible gun ownership. Keeping our children and society safe remains our top priority, and the NRA will continue to focus on keeping our children safe and securing our schools, fixing our broken mental health system, and prosecuting violent criminals to the fullest extent of the law." That statement from the NRA. But this is a really tough story when you start thinking about just how many lives have been impacted by gun violence. Sandy Phillips, just one of many stories that we've heard again and again and again being repeated. And so it's a perspective as we keep in mind as we go forward in this.